Welcome back, guys, to Seek the Beast on the Mindcrack Feed the Beast server! We're back in the secret base, and it's time to start preparing some defenses in case, as is probably inevitable, people start trying to find out my location. So there's only so many places in the world where I could have carved out a space this large and still be underground. So, if I'm gonna start messing with people more and more, we need to have some things prepared if people ever decide to show up or to look for us. And so today, we're gonna start working on that. I've talked about this before, actually, that I wanted to make a stupid amount of warded glass. Just to refresh in the Thaumonomicon. We can make warded stone, we can make warded glass, we can make warded doors, we can make warded pressure plates, and any of these things we place are indestructible except by the person who made them. Even a nuclear bomb can't destroy warded glass or a warded door or arcane pressure plates. So they are a very good way to guard your base, plus it leaves a sort of transparent layer so people who come by once my location is discovered. So people that come by will be able to look in and see all the crazy things going on, which is will be a neat visual effect. It's like putting this whole thing in a glass vial or something. So to do that, we're going to need some materials, and I've already started working on this in a previous video. A lot of glass, thaumium ingots, and zombie brains. So the glass, I already set up a mechanism for right here. You flick this switch right there, and it sends stone over to my macerator smelter setup, and then once it gets smelted, it gets sent through here down the green line, and there used to be a chest here, but I've moved it now that I updated my my Thaumcraft platform over here. It comes right over here, right up into this guy. Okay, and I can get plenty of thaumium, the Thaumcraft based metal. I get plenty of that just by some metal and some fricantatio. It's fairly easy to get a lot of this, especially with all my quarries going nonstop. The one thing I would be hard to get are zombie brains. So I've got some based on I did some more abandoned mineshaft caving, found more in chests, got more from killing angry zombies, but there's a better way to do it, because I'm gonna need so many of them. So I have made an angry zombie tier 5 spawner. So we're gonna be using that. Now I think one of these guys has metal bars in it for making a cage, I think. Whoops. Let's turn that back around the right way. I think, unless I changed it, maybe it was this one. Overclocker, heat vent, iron bars, plan, advanced heat plant. I just need to make one more of these. So I have one for each of my spawners. Okay, and then let's put those back. Okay. So, we need to place a zombie spawner somewhere. I think I'm going to place it in a vertical tower here and just make a basic falling trap, use a gong to pick up the stuff, and then have the items transferred via pipe to a chest right here, which is sort of going to be a mirror of this one. But before we do that, let's do a few updates about the wiring. So I made a video trying to figure out a way to make a one-button up-down elevator from scratch, basically. Just trying to figure out things on my own. I had a lot of fun. I got a lot of fulfillment, I guess you might say, out of figuring something out from scratch, even though this is far from the most efficient setup out there. The one dock used at the penguin enclosure is smaller than this, and I figured there were ways to make it better, and oh boy, were there ways to make it better. So let me show you something that's a little better. So on the Reddits, I'm not original at all. That's the person's username on Reddit. He suggested I do this, and this takes one, two, three circuits. one of these toggle latches, and then two timers, and a little bit of red alloy wire and a micro block to keep these wires from connecting. And that does the job of this section right here and those two. So everything except the selector to go one way or the other. So let's see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 circuits. And basically what he's done, he's taking out all of the pulse formers and the repeaters. So you only need the timer, the other timer, and one toggle latch to control them. So this is basically what it does. When you hit the button, it turns off this toggle latch. This wire goes through here, which allows both these timers to go off. This one is the short one. Whoops. This one is the short one, which is sending power to the frame motor. And this one is the long one. When this one gets all the way back around, it's going to send power back to here and turn this latch back off. It's super simple. I knew there would be a simpler solution, but I never thought it would be this simple. And I was looking at this thing, and I was thinking, I wonder if I could even make it even a little smaller, mostly by taking out some of the red alloy wire. And I did, in fact, do that. So this is my configuration of what he made. So the button is right here. And these three guys are the same circuit as this. I just compacted it very slightly. You can see this one is 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks long. And this one's only 3 blocks long. And I also added a selector because we got to go up and down. And each time you click it, I want it to switch to the other one. So I needed to add something like this back in without duplicating the entire circuit again. And I thought back to what Doc had done at the Penguin enclosure, and I remembered he used a piston. And with a simple toggle latch and a piston, we can have two outputs. So this is output one, this is output two. And you would have like a wire going each way. And you can use the different color wires to make sure they don't connect. But this is my new version. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 by 4 for a one up, one button elevator. So when you click it, it'll pull the piston back before this guy goes around once, and then it'll start sending pulses to the output you selected. And then when it gets all the way back around, this guy is gonna shut it off by sending power through this block back to the toggle latch. And the next time it just goes to the other one. So it's much simpler. And in addition to that, I'm going to be using wireless redstone, which we'll get into in a future update. I'm not gonna be adding these elevators yet, not in this video. But that'll be, not only will that be more compact, but wireless redstone will allow me to not worry about where, like, concealing the wiring. So if I wanted to put an elevator to go from the little bedroom platform down to, I don't know, that guy, for instance, I was kind of worried about, where am I going to put the wiring? Am I going to have to hide it? But with that, I can just have wiring, like a floating block where the wiring is hitting, and just have the little receiver and sender. And that made another thought occur to me, that we're going to need another platform, specifically like some sort of control platform with like switches and levers all over it to turn things on and off. It'd be nice and science fictiony. Okay, but before we do that, let's add the zombie spawner. Okay, I think I'm gonna put it right here, just to the outside of where this guy is. So we'll dump it right there. And I'm going to give it a power on automatically so it's not dropping things. And then we're going to need, I guess I'll just go straight down. I think we'll need to drop 20 some blocks. They're going to have more life than normal zombies, I'm pretty sure. I didn't look up exactly how far I'd need to drop them. We'll just figure it out with a little good old trial and error. But let's try something like that. See if that will kill them. Ooh, little hover mode action. Okay, and then we can delete all these. Okay, get back up on here. Okay, there we go. Okay, go all the way back down, and then we're going to turn the thing on and off from down here. And eventually, I'll move the control to the control platform that I talked about. Okay, so let's see if that kills them. But we're gonna turn the thing on and off with a thalamic device. Yeah, they're dead. See if any of them live. Sometimes there's a slight random factor there, but they're definitely dying. Okay, let's see if we can. Turn off, buddy. I'm not interested necessarily in making this into an experience farm, so with a lot of these dropping traps, they'll be within one block of killing them, and you can switch back and forth between it being a dropping trap to get loot and a dropping trap to farm experience. But we can be a little bit precise here. Normally, I like to brute force things, as you can tell with my highly inefficient... Okay, hover mode, turn on, please. My highly inefficient wiring I did last time. Okay, he lived. Two of them lived. Okay, that's definitely too high then. Come get some zombies with your chain mails. Suck it! I have a newly acquired... I finally got around to making a bunch of thalamic tools. I made an axe of the stream, a sword of the zephyr. Put a bunch of enchants on it. I haven't renamed it though. I should probably rename it something funny. Like the rest of my gear. Let's see if this one does the trick. And then we're going to... it's not going to be made out of stone. I'm just trying to get the height right. We're going to make it out of these guys right here. The same materials as my other platforms. How about now? Okay, you're going to totally miss. I'm going to... Okay, you're all gonna totally miss. Great. Keep going. One of you please hit it. There you go. Two of them lived. Okay, well that's no good. So maybe we should just go back to the one I originally had. Hey guys. Suck it. Maybe I hit it right. I hit the nail on the head the first try, I think. Okay, I think that'll do it. Okay, a few things I did. I spent a little bit of too much time trying to put a sort of a glass cage around this. I actually used my warded glass, the little bit that I've made so far. And I decided, here, let's just put some down so you can see what I'm talking about. And let's get that out of the bar and get that on the bar. Warded glass is extremely minimal, which I like. I like that a lot, that it's very light. And it also connects the textures as you put more down, so the center is always very, here, turn off the UI where, so that you can't see the block outline. Yeah, it's very transparent. And I thought it was a little too light, and I decided if I'm going to use this in the base, it should only be once for the outer shell of protection. So let's take these down. And I realized I don't really need to put a vertical tunnel around this, or what would you call that, a shaft around the outside to make them fall down in a straight line. It's not really necessary. What I am going to do, we're going to have our little clay golem worker buddy here. Hey, buddy. We're going to put him like that, and he's going to make sure that thing stays full. And we want to make sure that he goes to any amount. What do you want me to keep in this container, master? Anything they drop, basically. Actually, no, just these brains. So they're going to drop brains. That makes me think I should probably have a second one. I'm not sure if they will drop... Okay, lag. I'm not sure if they will drop more than just... brains and zombie flesh. The zombie flesh I don't care about. Not really. But what we might want to do, now that I think about it, is create another golem and give him a space on the opposite side to deposit things that these guys are going to be dropping. So we'll have this. So I need to make another clay golem worker and another animation core. Okay, Thaumonomicon, tell me what I need. Well, Zisto, you're going to need either, let's see, should we make him speedy, strong, perceptive, or smart? He only needs to be carrying, he doesn't need to be smart or perceptive. Perceptive increases the range at which they see things, and that platform is pretty small. So let's make this guy a strong one. So we need an Earth Shard and a Golem animation. We need four bricks then, and a Nitor. Four bricks and Nitor. Okay, there's a Nitor. And do I have bricks in here? I should. Okay. Oh, that's right. I wanted to make this guy a Wand of the Adept. I wanted to make a super wand. Let's go ahead and do that now, actually. We need 32. Let's put on our magic smelting goggles. Magic smelting goggles. So we need 32 of that stuff. That's the wrong one. We've got 16 sitting in this guy, which means we need another 16, so we'll just drop three of these suckers in here. Lag? Did those go in? They did. Okay, so we've got 18 there, 16 there. That should have been enough. Unless this guy is too far away for this table to notice, which is possible, but whatever. We have these warded jars now, and let's just drop some more in here. Now that should be enough. There we go, Wand of the Thaumaturge! Zoom, I feel powerful now. Okay, so we can put this guy back in there. What was I gonna make now? Is there like an aura shifting around me? What is this? Oh, that's the magical stuff flowing. Okay, what was I gonna make? A golem animation core. Put this thing in here, and we're gonna need 8 of the dangly men and 8 of the super speed band. Okay. Which means we'll need 4 of these. And let's see, I'm just gonna put anything I have that has those. Oh, this'll do, 4 rubber balls. Oh, look at that. Oops, no, don't give me those back. That's not what I meant to click. Where'd it go? Give me back. So I don't need the slime balls, we can just do 4 rubber balls. Oh, that's very handy, I'll have to remember that. That's a very efficient way to make these guys then. So we can make that core, and I think I needed green. Yeah, a green earth shard. Open that up. Look how much more impressive that wand looks. And then we need 12 of these fish. I know they have a real name. I don't care. I'm going to use my name for them. All right, where's the fish? It's been a while since I did much research, so I've forgotten. I'm not going to use the clocks for fish. That's kind of a waste. I don't even know why the fish are in here, or the clocks are in here. This one has it. Okay. Go. Redstone. Alright, redstone. There we go. Okay, there's that. Now we need to take that and stick it in a clay golem worker. So we're gonna need 5 more clay bars, which I don't have on me anymore. Okay, put that there. And then make an X formation. All right, then we're gonna need 8 apples and 8 ghosts. Lovely. I do have apples in here, so we're gonna need 4 apples to make 8 apples. Don't question my math; it's impeccable. And then we're gonna need ghosts. We can do that with soul sand. All right, and you can see in the bottom left how my aspect is only goes up to 55, and people say that's because my silverwood trees are so close. And I need to get rid of them actually. Zoom. Okay, there's a. There's a strong one. I guess his hands glow when they're strong. Yeah, maybe I'll get rid of these guys and just deal with the flux a different way. Okay, so this guy is going to be set up on this one. And I want him to pick up... you know, we'll start with zombie flesh. And... No, no. We'll start with, I want this to be nothing. Go away. Oh, I have to go left and right. That's right. If there's anything else they drop, then we'll deal with that. Okay, and then the last thing to do, I could, so what we can do is we can set up a switch to turn the sucker on and off with a note block and link the note block up with a arcane ear up there. I am going to be making a sort of master control platform, though, so I may want to... Why didn't you fill that up, buddy? Hey, make with the water. He didn't fill it up. He always fills it up. I may have to replace him. He may have forgotten or something or glitched out. I'm going to be making a master control program. Master control platform, probably right up there in the next couple of episodes. So maybe we'll wait talk it up like that. But we can demonstrate how it works. Maybe I'll just... I'll go ahead and hook it up like this for now. And then we'll have a better setup later. Okay, so we're going to have it like that, and I'm not going to change the note. We're just going to keep it like that. Let me climb up here and put that guy there. Get rid of that lever. Okay, so what I've got here is a little toggle latch. When this little arcane ear hears that note, and it should be set to the same one. I'm not going to right-click it because that'll change the note. It'll toggle the toggle latch and turn the spawner on. And I need to get rid of the torch. All right, so let's see if it works right. Yep, perfect. Now I just need to make sure they don't fall on the pressure plate. Oh yeah, that's an issue. That's an issue. I actually need to get rid of that. Now, that right there is an issue, that he spawned up on that thing. No, I definitely don't want that happening. Definitely don't want that happening. Get out of here, buddy. Hey, go away. Get out of here. Okay, let's see if they'll still spawn. I can replace it with micro blocks. Ouch! Go away. Whoops. Okay, that's not a good setup. We probably need to move it that way. let's turn it off. Switch it over, buddy. There we go. Okay. I think you get the idea, though. Ooh, they didn't all die. They did not all die. Okay, so I need to do some editing. Whoa! And these guys aren't doing jack. Why aren't you doing anything, buddy? You're supposed to keep that stuff full. Oops. No. Oh, no. Crap. What am I doing? And I don't have a wand on me. Okay, I'll get you, friend. I'll get you, little clay buddy. But there... None of my golems are working, huh? So not only did this guy stop working, the guy down there isn't doing anything either. Let me go check on them again. Yeah, he's not keeping this chest full. Oh, no, I'm trying to right-click on him, and I'm blowing him away with this stupid sword. I'm not using this dumb sword anymore. Let's go get these guys. So the clay golem workers are supposed to keep an inventory full when there's items on the ground. Give me that guy back. Thank you. Unless I picked the wrong ones. I'm pretty sure I picked the right ones. There's one kind that will pick things up and put them in a chest, and another kind... maybe it's the iron golems I'm looking for. Let's pick up all these nice brains. These are what I was after anyway. Okay, so let's consult the book. Clay golems, we'll try and keep items you specify in the inventory it is assigned to. Oh, they fetch items from other inventories. So I made the wrong ones. All right. Made the wrong ones. They emptied the contents. Oh, so I guess I need just the basic clay golem. No, wait. Aha, I need a wood golem. Wood golems pick stuff up off the ground. All right, but you get the idea. We're gonna have to do a little bit of editing here because some of those jerks lived through the fall. I'm gonna have to lower this whole platform a few blocks. And I'm going to have to move the whole thing over a few blocks. There's always, it's more interesting this way anyway. Maybe I should just put more random aerial faith plates in the air just so that they are flying all over the crazy place. Yeah, but this guy definitely was not doing his job. All right, so give me that. Let's put him back at least. Ooh, my inventory's full. Okay, and I need to place him on that. There we go. Maybe this block right here confused him. Okay, buddy. Here, have a water bucket. And I want you to pick up water from the white and put it in there. Okay? Try not to get confused again. All right? No, don't get hurt. Okay. So anyway, I'm going to rework all this stuff. But it basically works. And it should start bringing glass there. Or not glass, brains there, glass here, and then we're gonna have one of these set up specifically just for making warded glass. And it's gonna be this one. That's why I wanted the Wand of the Thaumaturge, because it has so much power. So let's actually do a little bit. And I don't have much thaumium. I'm gonna have to make a bunch of thaumium. Okay, what else do we need? We need glass, so let's get... Oh, I don't have enough room in my inventory. But I'm gonna set it up so I can do a stack at a time. Yeah, that's the way we do it. And then make two stacks of thaumium. Okay, we'll go and put the warded glass there. Okay, and then we need thaumium, which takes per ingot of thaumium. We're going to be making so much of this stupid stuff. We need to make 8 metal and 4 magic. So each of these has 5. So we could... So with, let's see, with a multiple amount of thaumium and 1 iron, we could make a pretty decent amount, but that would be kind of grindy to do just 1 or 2 iron at a time. So let's actually grab a bunch of iron. I've got 56 stacks here. We'll just make a bunch. And I probably want to make another one of those super wands and then use this table here. Oh no, wait. No. We make the thaumium in the crucible itself, that's right. Okay, so let's empty out a little bit of my inventory. Don't need the clay, not right now. I'm gonna make, I'll fix the golem stuff later. And then we'll put this guy back here. And I'm gonna use this guy to make thaumium because he can do 1,000 at a time. Okay, and then we're going to need... Let's try making 32. Okay. 32. 256, yeah! Okay, so if I made 32, I'm going to need 32 times 4, 128 of those little sorcery thingies. Each of these has 6. Let's see... So 10 is 60, 20 is 120, and we need 128. So if we do 22 in there, that'll be a little bit over. And here, have some flux, world. Alakazamo! Yeah, 33 thaumium ingots. Excellent. No, I'm not trying to... Oh, God, this sword! Okay. Get off the bar, sword. You're not... I'm getting rid of you. You're done. You're done, son! Alright. Let's just do this much. So it only takes 10 vis each. So we could do this operation 100 times, which is more than a stack. So we can do a full stack at a time, and it doesn't require any special stuff like that. So right there, 3 more stacks of it, just from that. Okay, that should be better. Drop the platform 2 blocks. I moved it over 2 blocks. I made some more golems. I think we're ready to go. This guy's hooked up to just a normal redstone engine. If I have... You see this right now? You know what I'm thinking of doing? You can see the flux being absorbed by the silverwood tree there. I'm thinking of moving them outside of my base a little farther. You see the flux over here is dangerous. But the overall aspect, the amount of vis in the air is much higher. So I'm thinking of just maybe adjusting my trees at some point. Anyway, this should be ready to go. I made some more golems. So we've got a wood golem. I'm going to stick this guy on that inventory. He's going to pick up everything that drops here. Right? And sorry, master, I am just a simple wood golem, too dumb for anything complicated. That's fine. He just needs to pick things up and put them in there. And then this stone golem worker is also going to be assigned to this chest. And I've placed a magenta marker block under this chest. And we're going to tell him to pick up some brains and put them in that one. Now, if I'm just using an ordinary redstone engine right now, and if I get too big of a backlog, if it takes too long to cart things out of here. Here, alright, I want you to put this. If it takes too long, I'll either bring some cable over and turn this into an electric engine, or I'll extend one of these magma pipes and put a magmatic engine in here so that it carts things out, and then maybe just turn it on when it gets full to shuffle things up there. But we should be ready to go. Oh, I like how he's got the little color on his chest. That's the first time I noticed that. Do you guys have that too? Oh, and I figured out the problem with this guy. He was having problems getting to the cauldron here because the slab red power partial block thing, it was in the way. So this works now. He can get to it, no big deal. And I just put these slabs on the corner so I can still get up here and get a good angle to drop things. And yeah, look at his chest has a little white symbol on it. And this guy has a little gray symbol for all these gray markers. That's the first time I noticed that. Okay, let's do another test here then. There we go, all dying. And they're running around picking things up, awesome. And the stone golem there shouldn't really move much at all. And we should see, yeah, here comes the brains. And since they're dying instantaneously, they shouldn't really push around the golems and get in their way. And I don't think they would. I don't think they will try to attack the golems either. Awesome. Oh, lag. Please be dead. Okay, good. Yeah, just a little lag there. And this guy barely has to move at all. It actually doesn't look like he's moving at all because he's within range of both. So he just stands there and transfers things. And looks like he is keeping up with the demand. Yeah, see? Check this out. I probably should have made him a fast worker, but it doesn't really matter. He's strong, so he can carry twice as much. And the redstone engine seems to be keeping up. What happened to my dude? Where'd he go? Did he fall off? Oh no! Am I gonna have to put a ledge around this to keep them from falling off? Where did he go? You see him? He's not there anymore. Are you down here, buddy? And we're getting lots of items falling off the edges. I may have to make this platform a little bit bigger. And I may have to put some sort of ledge around it to keep the golem from falling off, which it appears... It appears that he's disappeared. Or he's down here somewhere. Okay, let's turn off the system. I think maybe I'll just make it a little bigger. And put a ledge around it, maybe. Maybe do both. Let's turn the thing off. See if he shows back up. Whoops. Where did you go, my friend? Did one of the golems, or one of the angry zombies hit you? Okay, buddy. Damn, you're quick! Anyway, we're gonna figure it out, And next time, oh, actually, let's do one more thing. One more thing. Lots of brains filling up. We've got lots of glass. And I made, click on that, I made more thallium ingots. So this guy holds 1,000, and it takes 10 per this, per operation. So we can do 640, we can do the whole thing. Smack. Oh, I guess I didn't have a full stack of brains in the middle. But you get the idea. There's a lot of warded glass, and we'll get to work on that next time. Hope you enjoyed the video, guys. See you later. Take it easy. Have a good day. Bye-bye.